Sunday Night Baseball sucks. If you're in any way a baseball fan, you've probably either heard or watched Sunday Night Baseball. This disaster featuring four people who don't mesh well, don't get along, are complemented by bad camera work, strange sounds, and an overall disaster of a viewing experience. So let's go in more depth on these issues and figure out what's so bad about Sunday Night Baseball. But first, a word from our sponsors. Alright, the first reason why I can't stand to watch this travesty of a network is the matchups. Yes, I know they need the best teams in baseball to play on national TV to make more money, but let's take a look at them this year. First of all, we need more of them. The Cubs play in three straight games at one point. Like, I don't want to see the Cubs all the time. I really don't. And I understand they're marketable, but for God's sakes, mix it up a little. And in the 15-game schedule they put out at the beginning of the year, the Yankees play in a third, the Red Sox play in a third. That's way too much, even coming from a Red Sox fan. I get you want to see the Yankees and the Red Sox once or twice against each other, but I want to see other teams, and it's only playoff contenders from the year before. And I don't speak for everyone, but I want to see young teams like the Padres with young stars like Fernando Tatis Jr. play, or teams like the A's with one of the best players in baseball in Matt Chapman. Because I'm a Red Sox fan, but I really don't need to see them playing in a third of the games. I don't. I see them all the time. I'd rather see these young teams with these explosive players. So, add new teams. And I understand that they're trying to do that midway through the year, but I like to see that at the beginning of the year when you know teams are going to be good, because some teams just get left out. Now, let's talk about the crew. And this is probably the main factor in all this. Everyone in this booth sucks. So bad. It is approaching Joe Buck and the Hall of Famer John Smoltz bad. They barely focus on the game and go to Buster only every 5 seconds for a pointless sideline report. I just want to watch the game, but these commentators talk over the game when things are happening. They miss things, and these interviews cover 3/4 of the screen, or sometimes these buffoons cut away completely from the game. It's one of the most annoying things I've ever seen on baseball. Also, this is sort of a bias, but I absolutely loathe A-Rod. Sometimes he has intelligent things to say, and I like him as an analyst, but usually it's just nonsense or obvious things that anyone can say. And he gets commended on when he gets something right, but it's something a third grader could have pointed out. And Matt Vasgersian, I love the guy, I think he brings so much energy to the table, but he needs to calm down a little. He's either super hyped or just dead. I don't understand him, he's so bipolar about this stuff, and unless something unbelievable happens, he doesn't need to scream. You don't need to scream in a game in April and July and June, you need to scream in October. Nothing really important is happening right now unless it's something unbelievable, and it gets old and annoying really quick. I feel like this group can't be redeemed, they have no chemistry, sometimes they don't speak for a couple minutes, sometimes all three talk over each other. It's probably the worst crew in baseball right now, and we're living in a world where Joe Buck is an announcer. And it's really disappointing because baseball really needs something like this. The NBA has great success on their national TV games, and same goes for Sunday and Monday Night Football. Thursday Night Football needs some help, but I digress. So what should they do? What does the abomination of a company like ESPN need to do to fix this? First of all, fire all the commentators and completely overhaul this disaster of Sunday Night Baseball. And I know it's not profitable to bring back the advanced Sunday Night Baseball, but please do it. It's just a personal thing. But getting back on track, they need to focus more on the game and find people that blend well together. It really shouldn't be that hard. There's probably thousands of people gunning for this job, and I could see them doing it quite easily. And I want to hear actual smart people talking about things that can appeal both to the casual and devoted fan. I also want to see way more teams on Sunday Night Baseball. I want them to expand it to mid-level teams and good teams. You don't need just the top teams because it gets boring real quick. It'd bring more fans and create more excitement for these MLB young stars. And that's what MLB needs to create more money and be more profitable in the long run. Well, that's all I got for you today. If you like this video and you want to see more, hit that subscribe button and also hit that like button. It really helps me out because I just hit 1,000 subscribers, which is absolutely insane. And if you have any other video ideas, tell me in the comments. I will be starting to do some out-of-the-park baseball content, but don't worry, that won't take away from my original content. If you have any questions for me, leave them in the comments below and I'll try to answer all of them. Until next time, I'll see ya.